Welcome to Nick's Garden. I'm a new gardener. I started in this year, 2022. I am doing a process today. I'm transporting my pepper and my squash into the 7-gallon container. I love these containers. These are really awesome. I'm going to show you a brief view of my new garden that I just built this year. It's not quite finished yet, but take a look. That's what I'm doing here in my backyard. And so I'm using these, like I said, 2 7-gallons. Today I'm using organic soil by Miracle-Gro. I normally make my own soil, but it's really hard to find some of the additives I need for my soil. So I decided to buy this, which is a really good price. Like I said, this is from Costco, about $7 and some change, which is a really good price for a 50-gallon bag. So that's what I'm using today. So here we go. We're going to get into the process. You just put your hands here, flip it over. I'm going to dig a hole first. And this is the pepper. I'm going to flip it over. You put it in there. I have my additives too. So, matter of fact, let me put a little bit. And what I do, a little handful. Sorry, sweetie pie. I mix that up in there. Sometimes I put a little moisture in here, but you can do it either way. It's probably really good to put a little moisture. So, I'll put a little blood meal in there. Just put a little handful. And worm castings, and you just mix it up really good. Okay, I'm gonna put a little moisture in there. Okay. And we're gonna water it down at the end anyway. So let's get that in there. Then I'm going to put just a little bit more of blood meal. Can you sit that beauty? Look at those roots. Just beautiful. Sit it in there and then you cover it. And I'm going to put a little more dirt on top of it. I got to go get some more dirt. I'm sorry, soil. We don't like to say dirt. Okay, so I'm gonna do that at the end. I'm gonna put the squash into its final home. We'll do the same process. Pour some all-purpose plant food in there. Some worm castings, a little handful, some blood meal. And what you do, like I said, it's so easy. Take your sticks out. You can always reuse these for another plant. It was kind of keeping the plant sturdy, which is really great. Flip it over. Look at that roots. Just beautiful. Just beautiful. We'll mix that up a little bit. Make that hole. A little bit of worm castings. Put that in there. I'm going to set it right on in there. And it might fall apart just a little bit. But what you're going to do is cover this whole thing up with soil. And just give me 1 second. Let me go get some more dirt.
Ready.
Okay, so I did put some more soil into the container here. And I filled it up. This can actually get a little bit more. So I have ran out of the soil that I purchased from Costco. So this is my homemade soil that I make my own. It has vermiculite in it, perlite, and peat moss. And I can go into that in another video. But what I'm going to do is put some more here, because you want to fill it up as much as you can to right to the bottom of the root.
And is it okay if a little soil get on the plant? You can always spritz that off. I have a spray bottle that I'm gonna spritz that off as much as I can and kind of like shake the plants so that they can be clear of this soil. Okay, so that looks pretty good. And it's probably best to put it right in the center for purposes of planting. So if you go off top of it and see how it's right here, it's good if you put it right in the center for future ones. I'll keep that in mind next time. So I'm gonna go over here. This one needs require a little bit more soil as well. So, and I'm gonna pull these little leaves off from the bottom. That helps to encourage the plant to grow. Right, so let me get some water, and I'm gonna pull it over it. You know what? What I should have done first was put my let me put this over to the garden, so you can follow me over to the garden, and I'm gonna set it right here for now, and I'm gonna. Give me 1 second. I'm coming right back. I forgot. I wanted to also grab some of my saucers. I like to put saucers under there to catch the water. So let me put this here. And there we go. This is kind of small, but it'll work for now. I'm going to go over here, put that in there. And I'm going to get the other plant. And it's very important because there have been times that I have actually forgot to put my labels in. And then I was like, what is this? So when it grows out, of course I know. So I'm going to take my pepper label I made and stick it in there so that it kind of lets you know when you planted it, what type of vegetable it is. And the other one was a little teeny stick that had squash on it. I mean, I use what I have. So, that's what I had at the time. I'm going to stick that in there. And let me get a little bit more water. Like I said, I'm going to go ahead and grab these and water them down. And that's pretty much the process. So, I just want to thank you for stopping by to watch Nick's Garden. Have a good day and like and subscribe. Have a great one. Peace out.